Welcome, everybody, to the Adventure Archive, presenting Merc Borg Session 1. My name is Jason. I will be the GM tonight. How is everybody doing? I am joined by, you know her, I thought she was in many things, but she is only, in fact, in one thing, but now two things. Jess, tell us a little bit about Nagel, who you are playing.
I am a hermit, and...
What kind of hermit, though? Let's hear what kind of hermit.
Oh, God. Why me first? Let's see.
Esoteric, right?
Oh, yes.
Esoteric hermit.
Esoteric hermit. I'm a nihilistic, worried esoteric hermit with long hair with at least one cockroach in it.
Perfect.
Yes.
And Ryan, you know Ryan. Everybody knows Ryan. He's the DM for Dark Kingdoms and the, I like to call him the resident DM of the Adventure Archive. He also has his own channel, Melee After Dark, where he does a variety of things. So, Ryan, tell us who Nifel is, a little bit.
Yeah, I am Nifel. I am the prophet of the dead god Gnostis, Lord of Panic.
Is it Gnost or Gnostis? Was it Gnostis?
I am Gnostis. I think it is Gnost. I think you are correct. Where did I...
That's right. Because I was like, I remember we saw that.
Yeah. Oh, did you say I could right-click and fully pop it out?
Yeah, if you right-click a tab in Foundry, it'll pop it out.
Anyway. Obituary. Gnost. Herald of Panic. And I have my steadfast companion... Arvant with me.
Yeah. You want to tell a fun fact about Arvant from a previous life?
Oh, I once knew a man named Arvant. Do you want to say it right now?
No, do you?
Go ahead. There was a previous iteration of Arvant in an off-stream game that we had. And I'll wait until the person who plays Arvant hears that this is Arvant, and then I'll talk about it.
Yeah. Okay. We'll wait. We'll wait for Arvant. All right. Moving on. We have Ducky, who has an amazing channel. He's a great artist, gamer. He does all kinds of things. He was going to even sculpt his own mask for this, which is I can't wait to see it.
It's almost done.
So tell us, who is Abhorred Denies the Flesh?
So Abhorred Denies the Flesh is a pale one, a nihilistic fellow who is just waiting for the inevitable. He's here to observe. And he's got a mask made out of the shell of the egg he was hatched from and picks his nose so hard he bleeds.
That's the quote, everybody. Let's see how many clips we can get of Ducky saying that. We can make a great montage. All right, and finally, last but not least, Janelle, who you know from Theros as Fakira. She even played, who was the Shadow Fae in Dark Kingdoms? I can't remember. What was the name? Oh, you're on mute.
Sylvan.
Oh, can we get some mute in the chat? Can we please get some mute in the chat? We have our first mute of the evening.
Sylvan. She was.
Let's see if we can get our first misery. Yes, and she single-handedly made the Adventure Archive website. So, Janelle, who are you playing?
I'm playing Hargha. She's an elderly occult herb master. She tends to stoop a bit as she carries her very, very heavy sack around, but it makes it easier for her to look for herbs and stuff that she turns into potions.
Awesome. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the game before we begin. So if you are not familiar with Merc Borg, it's actually pronounced, it even says so in the book, Merc like murder. Borg, it's a Swedish word that means dark fort or dark castle. And it is made by two gentlemen, designed and written by Pelle Nilsson. All the graphic design and art is by Johan Noor and Dead People. And it's published by Free League. It's won 5 Ennies last year. 4 golds, 1 silver. So That is quite the feat for such a small game, and I'm very much looking forward to it. But as in Dark Kingdoms, this is a dark fantasy, apocalyptic. It is the tale of a land only known as the Dying World, and it is on the brink of an apocalypse, and all of the people therein are just trying to have some sort of existence in this bleak world, searching for hope, maybe perhaps turn the tide, who knows. But that is Merkborg. It is an OSR style game, so very rules light, and as they say, heavy everything else. But I like to equate this with, and if you're here for our Zero session, with Evil Dead. So it's gory, it's over the top, but in kind of a, it's so ridiculous, it's funny. So hopefully we don't turn your stomach too much, and hopefully we make you laugh more than anything else.
And so, I don't know if you think the way that I think, but when I think Evil Dead, I always think Evil Dead 2.
Evil Dead 2. Sure, yeah.
All right.
There you go. And then one other thing I sadly forgot to mention last session is this amazing soundtrack for Merkborg. I contacted the gentleman from Heimat der Katastrophe in Italy. One artist by the name of Noel did the soundtrack for Merkborg, and they very generously allowed us to play it on stream here. So I highly suggest you check them out. I'm going to drop a link in the chat. They have about, I don't know, 50 different albums on there with various artists. It's a genre called Dungeon Synth, kind of reminiscent of 80s video games, but it's changed my life, that genre. I love it. And then let's see, moving on. Let's talk about general Adventure Archive updates really quick. So the first one I'd like to talk about is we actually have, I can never do this. We are going to give away a copy tonight of the official book, Merkborg, so you too can kill a bunch of people and visit the dying world.
Let me actually create a giveaway and get that going real quick. Completely forgot about that.
So please hang out till the end if you'd like to win a copy. And Ryan's going to create that. Anything else? Do we have any other housekeeping before we delve into this this dark and bleak place? Because we're going to get evil, everybody. So, and there might be some rotten flesh. So I know we don't have a rotten flesh emote, but we do have a ham one. So if we can get some evil hams, that would be amazing. Some evil rot. Get evil. No, really. How is the audio, everybody? Yeah, look at that. Thank you. I know I had some issues with it last time. Is anything too quiet? Anybody too loud? Let me know, and we will adjust. Balance is great. Perfect volume. Awesome. This time I can hear it, which I like, so I know actually what I'm playing. But as soon as Ryan is ready, we can begin. Let's see, what else? I'll describe some of the rules so you guys get to look forward to while I play this. So as I said, it's rules light. It's a D20 based game. And you roll against a difficulty rating modified by a, you know, it's pretty standard kind of D&D. It's modified by up to a plus. What are you guys at? Like, most of you are plus zero, right? Zero. And there's only a handful of abilities. There's agility, presence, strength, and toughness. There's also a unique feature. Oh, yeah, I should probably talk about this. So if you guys check in the bottom left of the screen, we have blesses, which you know what those are. We have banes, you know what those are. The only difference is I'm changing it a bit, so it's going to be a d4 to any roll, not just a d20. So if they would like to add it to damage, they are more than welcome to. We will see how we will see how OP that gets. I don't know yet, but the one unique identifier with Merkborg is the omens. So that is the same price as a shield. And what those do is the players get those. Those are in the white text below their portrait where it says 2 out of 2, 4 out of 4. And that is how many times they get to use those per day. So what those do is they roll a d20, or actually they can choose one of these items below. They can deal max damage, reroll a die, lower damage by d6. And the reroll a die could be for themselves or anybody else, which is a cool feature. Neutralize a crit or fumble, lower one test DR by -4. So everybody's maxed out. Ryan's more than maxed out, but that's okay. And so feel free to contribute to that, any of those. Because we'll see how it goes. Everybody has like 5 hit points, so it'll be great.
Okay, so the Morkborg giveaway is created and up and running. Amerisun's already entered. Just hit !! Giveaway if you want to win the Morkborg game book. Everyone, did I make it hopefully I made it followers only. If you don't follow us, follow us. And if you sub, you get 2 tickets, not 1. I feel like there was something else I was supposed to do. Is that it?
I think that's it. I think we got everything. Chat, I will do my best. I have a lot of windows up. I'll do my best to keep an eye on the chat, but our lovely players will keep an eye out for me in case I miss anything. So if everyone is ready, let's get some evil in the chat. Let's begin our first session of Morkborg Graveslift Wanting. I think I need a little bit of a different mood and music here.
Bless already for the Dexter.
Oh, all right. Let me get that bless. So he should be at 5. I'll save that out.
Oh, I get one as well. Thank you, Steph.
All right, so you're at 5. Yeah. Let's get the blesses and everything's out of the way.
And Jess.
And Jess, okay. So you're 5. Jess is at 7. Wow. They may survive the evening. I hope they do. Okay. So the way this is going to work, everybody. Oh, look at all these great filters we have here. Look at this. They're looking quite goth.
Or your favorite metal band.
I hope Ducky muffles his voice the entire time. That's what I hope. All right, well, so the way this is going to work, I'm going to run non-combat initiative in the order you see here displayed. So Jess will go first, Ryan second, Ducky, and then Janelle. And then we can freeform it for a lot of the game, but I feel like if we start getting it too much heavy-weighted in certain players, we'll push it around. So here we go. Oh, man. Thank you, Papa Jedi, for the cheer. 100 bits. Oh, that's another one for Ducky.
Yep.
So Ducky's at 6.
Okay, let me get totals so I can make sure that we're... So you have how many?
Who, me? Baines?
Yeah.
I have 5. Yeah. I should have 5, I think. Jess should have...
Janelle has...
Janelle has 5. That's what I see.
Oh. All right, I have...
Right,
so
oh, that's
there.
Right.
Look at the stream. I have 5. Ducky has 5?
Ducky has 6.
Oh,
that's
six.
What I have is 6, yeah.
An and then she has 7, and then I'll keep the tally from there just to make sure.
And you're 5 and 5. All right, let me do this one last save, and then we will keep tallies and take a break in a moment to redo it as needed. All right, so we are beginning. What's up?
Sorry, real quick, last one. I think Janelle just had another one.
Oh, Janelle's got another
she'll
one.
She'll start, she'll have 6.
Yeah. All right. You guys are topped off. So I think, oh, and another thing I forgot to mention, everybody, this is a player facing role game. So I will roll very few dice, only mostly for like random encounters and stuff like that. So they'll get twice as many opportunities to use all these great tools, these blesses and omens. All right, let us begin. And we are going to start with Nagel. Well, yes. I'll let me start.
Oh.
I just pulled up a document.
Oh. You just dot dot dotted and I,
oh, I'm
I
sorry.
Thought I had
I didn't,
to
I didn't,
fill the space.
No, you're good. You're good. You ran hard, nearly out of breath, bare feet bleeding. They're after you. Who? You don't know. But you did know what they sought. The book. You used it, and the beasts it summoned gave you the time to flee. But you knew the cost. You knew the odds, so you ran. The forest ended impossibly, because the Sarkash never ends. But that day it did. An open plain, nowhere to hide. The cursed moon, which was usually hidden by clouds, stared down at you with a red eye. With no other choice but forward, you bolted onto the plain, the grass lashing at your legs until they too bled. Your sprint took you to a small ruin, looked to have been a farmstead once, now a heap of rubble marked with strange symbols written in dried blood. A voice beckoned you, pleaded, a young woman, strangely one who looked somewhat like you, holding a bundle of red. She told you all she wanted to do was to please Verhu. "Will you take him?" she asked. "To the priests." She held the child out to you. So tell me, what did Nagel say to this woman?
I cannot take your baby.
Please, you must.
I have one day food, just for me.
Outside, the sound of armor, of voices. They found you. She looked in the direction of the voices, back to you. You saw the scream bubbling in her throat. When you heard the cries of her death at the blades of the men, you knew that it would only be a matter of time before they realized it wasn't you, that she didn't have the book. The blood of the child was cold, with no time for a proper burial, and no words for it, you lowered it down an abandoned well on a bucket, hoping at least that would save it from the wolves or the dark work of cultists. But you lingered too long. The men found you, as did their blades. Still you held on to that book as they cut you to ribbons, never letting go, the book burning hotter than the blood, and you fell. So now, you wake in darkness. You look up, you see a, it almost looks like a moon ahead. It's a very bright light, crisscrossed with clouds. But there's a black circle eclipsing that light. And when you feel around, you notice that you're sitting in liquid. It's about a foot. What do you do?
I look around and try to touch anything that's around me.
So when you look around and you feel around, you feel cold stone, moss between them. You know you're in a well. Very deep.
It feels kind of like home, but I would like to get up.
Okay. So you stand up.
Yeah.
Just like I said, you're standing in about a foot of water. There doesn't appear to be any way to climb out, but and the bucket is just out of reach, hanging on a rope.
Is there anything at my feet? or in the water?
Just water. Yeah, just water. Maybe a couple of dead leaves kind of floating around, but nothing of substance.
I'm gonna... Do I have my bag?
You have everything that's on your sheet. You have all of your belongings.
Okay. I'm gonna take out my femur.
Okay.
Not my femur, but, you know.
Yeah,
the femur I have. And try to hook the bucket.
Okay, it's still just out of reach. You can't quite get it even with the femur. But as you do this, a few moments go by, and the ground, it begins to move, begins to convulse. You feel your feet sinking, as if in quicksand.
Okay.
You feel something pierce your foot, but you step away just in enough time. And then all of a sudden, you hear the voices of children around you. And then when you look to those voices, you see that the spaces between the stones have become mouths. They're deep and black. And they speak to you. They say, "Come back to us. Mother's womb is warm. Mother's breast is full." And I need you to roll me a d4.
Okay. Two.
That is how many rounds you have to get out of this well before you are consumed by it. So let's move on to Ryan. Cliffhanger, everybody. All right, Ryan. Nifel, they did not listen. You reached the village of Hurat with blessings of Nost a few days ago, but your blessings were answered with laughter, with mockery, and that you should go to the Bergen crypt to join your dead god. But you persisted. The voices told you to. They promised that a cleansing would be near. You earned the ears of a few, then the minds. Few became enough, and enough is what you needed to make things right. Your flock overpowered them, mounted them with nails to the very symbol of the basilisk they worship. A cross, two and two-headed. And while this happens, a man, one of your flock, comes over to you. And he's holding a candle, which I should probably remember to bring up. And do we see it on the screen? Let me get this one out of the way. So he hands this candle out to you. What did Nifel do?
This member of my flock, the flock that worships Nost.
Yeah, it appears as if he is giving you the honor to burn these heretics.
So snatch the candle from his grasp. And okay. I'll march over and cast it down, start the flames.
You did indeed start the fire with a candle's flame. And you watched them for some time, closing your eyes to the heat of their deaths, until you felt a presence, your flock before you, waiting for what you promised. Wait. What had you promised? Salvation was what, but it's not what they asked. They asked for coin, for riches. That damned skull must have been him, always ruining things. But with the bad comes the good, an omen this was, because there are other heretics to cleanse elsewhere, After a time, your flock grew impatient, and nothing you said appeased them, so they chased you through the village, casting the very fire that used to burn their neighbors. You found yourself in a small chapel, a hut really, with an altar of she, the only thing made of stone, safe from fire. You reluctantly crawled beneath it, and strangely, the eyes on the twin heads of the basilisk somehow stared down at you through the altar. And you wondered if she speaks to the villagers as Nost speaks to you. How long until they find you? And you too wake in darkness. It's an oppressive cold around you. And as you feel around you, it's not stone. It's not the stone of the altar you remember. You feel splinters, knots. And as you look down at your feet, you see moonlight streaming in through one of them. What do you do?
Am I able to rise?
No, so you seem to be enclosed in a box of wood.
How close is it to me? Is it coffin size?
It's coffin size. You deduce it as coffin size.
When I feel the wood, does it feel new? Does it feel old?
When
I push, does it give?
It gives a little bit. So if you'd like to, I want you to roll a strength check for me. And it does, as you press into it, it feels somewhat worn, somewhat, you know, soggy. Like it might have some give, so it's only going to be a DR8. Okay. You succeed. You got a 15. So you push the lid away. You could see that it was affixed with nails, just like the ones that, well, smaller versions than the ones that you nailed those heretics to some time ago. But you feel something pulling you down at your feet. And I want you to roll a d4. Three, okay. Three rounds. These are ticking clocks, everybody. That's what these are. All right, let's move on to Ducky. And we're just doing these rounds in the beginning. All right, Abhorred denies the flesh. The bog hag had raised you as well as she could have, born of her own egg and all. You took a liking to the taste of flesh, both fresh and not, an irony the bog hag embraced when naming you. Abhorred denies the flesh. You were a little hunter, catching all manner of things that fell prey to the swamp. It was a peaceful existence until a young woman named Fella Mouse lost her way in the swamp and found her way to you. She seemed to be drawn to it when the bog hag was playing a fluted horn, some old relic she told you that had been in her family for years. The hag beckoned her in, fed her, showed her out of the swamp, even gave her a map. The next day she was gone as well as the horn. The bog hag was furious and devastated. Nothing you could say or do would pull her from her fugue. You knew you had to find it, so you set off on her trail, leaving the comfort and safety of the swamp. Days and weeks you traveled until finding her performing in a tavern near Lake Onda. Her music hypnotized the patrons and she picked them clean. Finally, she retired and you found a way up to the window of the room she rented, the horn gleaming in the moonlight. So tell me, what did Abhorred denies the flesh do in this moment?
Is the window unlocked?
You test it, and it is.
I'm gonna go ahead and try to open the window slowly.
Okay, roll me an agility. And it's gonna be a DR12. So you gotta get a 12 or higher. Okay, so, You find the latch, and it just pushes open. Unfortunately, there is a rusty hinge, and it squeals, and the rust pours away. But she doesn't wake. However, you hear footsteps coming down the hall. They kick the door open, and you see it's these men that she had hypnotized with her music, with the very music that came from the horn of your beloved bog hag. So, you almost had it, but were run down by those men, and were forced to flee back to the swamp. You returned to a woman, changed, livid, tortured, thinking you abandoned her, cursing your name, cursing you. She used your namesake in her sorcery, causing the flesh rotting from your face, so you would never leave her again. Luckily, you kept the shell you were born from and fashioned a mask from it. When you had the courage to tell her of your failure, her wound split open. She bound you with a spell and hid you beneath the water, no air to breathe. The tangled roots of a tree through the murky water, the last thing you saw. And you see them again, now you think. But you're not underwater any longer. Your flies swarming, you smell decay. You can't move, you can't breathe. Something is smothering you, wet and rotten. I need you to roll me a d4, please. Ooh. One. The most unlucky number. Don't forget, you have omens if you would like to reroll a die. Or you could use a bless, I guess. It's up to you.
Yeah, I'll use a bless and reroll.
Use a bless. I think for D4 rolls, maybe it's a one. So I'll just say you have a two then. So let me mark that bless off. And what I need you to do now is roll me a strength test. Standard difficulty, 12. What did you get? 12. Look at that. Perfect. Okay. So you push free enough to get some air, but you taste all of this just wet, rotten flesh coming into your mouth, even despite your little shell. And it's becoming very difficult to breathe. And finally, we will go to Janelle. And this time I'm going to actually open the image before I start talking. Harga, you squeezed his neck, surprised at how weak he was. Horrid Harga, Harga the Hungry, Harga the Hog. Your nephew had many names for you, and for years you accepted them because you had promised your sister you would raise him like your own, away from the vile cities to show him the beauty of a simple life. He's struggling again, so you kneed him in the chin. His half-severed tongue dangled between bloody teeth. In the Sarkash forest you raised him, where you'd grown up. There you had survived in the land and the meager profits of your concoctions, ushering the cursed boy into manhood. And you felt a pop beneath your thumbs. His eyes went wide, and you eased your grip because you saw your sister in those eyes. Manhood had come quickly, and the words became slaps, punches. He hit you so much you now have trouble keeping the spit in your mouth. Your hands had grown strong, so strong from gathering Sarkash's bounty with the toughest roots. You showed him just how strong until he bit the rest of his tongue off and it flopped to your feet. Raven hopped in through the open door and snatched it up. The arteries on his neck stood out like roots. And tired of hearing his whimpering, you dug in with your nails, blood spattering your face. And you hear something on the door. Or you heard something. Harga! And you recognize the voice as Svind. He's the man who'd helped you sell your brews in the nearby town. He stood in the doorway, a trail of the blood the raven left behind running between his legs. So, at this moment, what What did Harga do?
He was possessed. I had to.
He just
kind of... My poor boy.
He stares at you, just shocked. His eyes just glued to this boy, with his just blood coming out of his mouth everywhere. His eyes are rolled back in his head. And his response is running. He ran out the door. Soon men arrived with weapons, with ropes, ready to string you up like the witch they'd always known you were. You ran, but not very far. Your old bones weren't made for it anymore. You wish they'd given you the decency of letting you see the forest's twisted beauty while they strung you up, but instead a black bag was pulled over your head. And you too wake in darkness. You feel your nephew's neck still, fresh on your hands. Then you see your hands, and they're coming for you, slipping around your throat, and they squeeze. You feel a rope burning on your neck, and you begin to strangle. You kick your feet. What do?
I have all of my stuff or no?
Yeah, you have everything.
I'm going to try to grab the knife.
Okay.
And cut it. Cut the net, the rope a bit.
Okay. So why don't you roll me a... let's do a toughness test to see if you can fight through the agony of strangling.
Eight. I'm gonna bless it.
Go for it.
Yeah.
These blesses are gonna come in handy.
Okay. So 12.
Perfect. That's enough. You cut through the rope and you fall to the ground. And you're on your hands and knees, yeah, gasping for breath. And we are going to go back to Nagel. So, as I said, you heard those voices. You see those mouths. And you feel the ground at your feet start to consume them. Start to feel feet. Not feet, sorry, teeth. No toe jokes, guys. Just kidding. So as you look around these mouths that keep whispering to you, they might be good enough to become a foothold or a handhold. Just maybe.
I will try to shove my feet and my hands into these little mouths and crawl up the well.
Okay, strangely, they don't seem to mind, but what I'm going to ask you to do is roll a strength check to see how far you can scale up this wall.
Okay.
And see if you can maybe just get to that rope.
Definitely gonna have to bless this. Oh wait, that wasn't even a strength check with it. How strong am I? Oh, great. -3. A bless probably won't even help.
Oh, yeah, look at that. -3. Don't forget, you have omens, and omens will allow you to lower one test difficulty rating by -4.
Okay,
so
I mean, I do have an omen, so I think I'll have to do that.
You
want to
use an omen?
Yeah.
Okay, so now your difficulty is an 8.
Oh, then I won't bless it.
Then you won't bless it. Okay. So let me remove your omen. Oh, in chat, they can't go beyond the max of their omens that they can based on their character class, just so you know. All right. So you grab hold of these mouths and you work your way up and you're starting to feel confident and the rope is just right there. What do you do?
I guess I'll try to reach it.
You can reach
grab it. Okay.
And there's a big bucket dangling.
I'm gonna tug on it, make sure it's secure.
Yeah, it feels secure enough.
Okay. I guess I'll try to climb up the rope.
Okay, roll me another strength test. DR 12.
Oh god, I did it again.
Did what again? Do you want to use another omen?
yes.
Because you only got an 8. Wait, do you have a -3 though?
Yeah.
So make sure to roll it in the character sheet, and that'll take care of your modifier.
Sorry.
Okay.
Oh. I'll take that first one.
All right, you reach out, and unfortunately, you slip down back into the water. With a splash.
Wait, did I use my omen?
Did you use an? Oh, you want to use another one, right?
Yeah, and then I'm gonna bless it.
So now you're down to 2, and you're using a bless.
Yeah. So.
What'd you get?
See, 5. Yeah, 6. So still splashing.
All right, splash down there. And as you land, the voices seem to just become louder and even more convincing. And you're starting to feel as if the bottom of this well might be just where you deserve to be. All right, Nifel. So you're standing up in a coffin and you feel something. You succeeded that strength test, right? There? Oh, mute! Can we get some mutes in the chat, please? Please get some mutes, if anybody has any mutes. No? Oh, there we go. Janelle's got all the mutes.
Janelle's got mutes. So, real quick, exactly what do omens do exactly for us? Oh, I see it at the bottom. Deal max damage, reroll a die, lower damage by d6, neutralize crit or fumble, or lower ones, 2s by dr minus 4. Okay.
And I am going to put you somewhere. Give me 1 second. Bring you into what you see. And tell me when you can see that. Hopefully it works.
I get my character. Did you say we could pop the character sheet out somehow? Because it's just kind of in the middle of everything.
I don't think it can leave the browser window now.
Gotcha. Okay, well, I'll just close it for now. I can see this.
Okay. Let me hide that monster. He's not there. That's just my vision. There we go.
So let me hide this monster that's there but not there real quick. All right.
That's so I can see the map. I can share the player's map and not show what I see.
Gotcha.
So you're standing there in the in this coffin. You look around and you see that you're not in this chapel anymore at all. It's a crypt, and there's a assortment of just shattered pottery urns and things like that around. The only light coming from here, though, is from a candle behind you. Single candle, and there's a door in front of you closed. But you do see something right before that door, and it's looks like a soot stain, but in the shape of a man or a human. But that soot stain goes all the way up to the door where you can see two hands are placed there. And there's a series of windows around you, letting in some of the moonlight.
Is Arvant with me?
Yeah, Arvant is with you, of course. Everything, yeah, everybody has everything, by the way.
Okay. What do we do, my friend? Can I go look at the windows?
Yeah, sure. Yeah, feel free to move your token as you want.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
And then when I'm looking out the windows,
can you see out
Arvant's
the windows?
Looking at with me. Okay. Can I see out the windows?
I don't know. Can you? Like, is the actual like fog of war working?
I see fog, but I see the map around it.
Oh, you do. Okay. Yeah. So outside, you see what appears to be a graveyard. There's headstones just kind of arranged haphazardly. There doesn't seem to be any sort of order. There's twisted trees everywhere, and the fog is just very, very thick.
And the door.
Mm-hmm.
Is it just a handle? Does it look like there's a bar?
It looks like a handle. But you can see that the, like I said, the soot mark. It's like very clear prints, like of a man, and they trail down the length of the door, leading to a body, what appeared to be a body there at one point.
Mm. All right. Are the things that are in the scene right now in the scene? Like, is there like a...
Yeah.
Basically, I don't know if I can click like I can in Roll 20, but this thing on the ground to the, it's to my right looking at it, this like stick here between the two windows on the right.
A stick. Oh, yeah, yeah. So, yeah, that down there, that looks like a stake.
Could I pick that stake up?
Of course you can. You can pick that stake up. Just want, yeah, and watch. Make sure to watch your encumbrance too. So I'm not sure if you're maxed out or not.
Oh, I don't think so.
Okay.
I'm only carrying 4 of 8 things.
Okay.
So I'll either add this or discard it. And now the handle. It turns though, right? Like, it's like I grab it and like rotate it as opposed to like, yeah, because we're not in an office building in 2021. It's
yeah, you actually, and you can click it if you would like. You click the little icon there. Hopefully you see one.
All right.
So, yeah, you can interact with doors and things.
So I'm clicking it, but it's got an orange outline on it.
Yeah. So it's, you find that it's locked.
Does it look like I could break through the windows?
Yeah, you might be able to squeeze through them. They're pretty small. But it would probably take some time. Like stained glass.
So then, yeah, I'll take the stake and I'll just smash out one of the windows as much as I can.
Okay. You smash it out. Kind of move, you know, the shards out of the way as much as you can.
And then I'll try to make my way out.
Okay, you notice something strange as you kind of reach your hands through the window, they stop where the glass used to be. You try again, same thing. You think it was your imagination at first. But yeah, you can't seem to push your arms through.
Arvant, we're trapped.
All right, on that note, I'm going to move to... Go ahead.
No, no.
What were you going to say? Okay.
No.
All right, Ducky. Let's move you to where you are. So these... this rotten flesh, these entrails that you can now tell they are, just continue to suffocate you. And so I need you to roll me a toughness check. DR 12, so 12 or better. Perfect. Okay. You actually have to eat your way through it because it just seems to keep coming. So, but you're very familiar with that flavor. It's a little bit more rotten than you would like, but yes. And this, let's see if it works there. You find yourself in this massive pit. There's bodies just in various states of decay. And you're just kind of knee deep in it right now, standing upright. And as you look around, you can see the tree line. You can see you're in this massive graveyard. It's seemingly endless. The fog kind of obscures most of your vision, but above that line of fog, you see just the dark, twisted tree line. And even beyond that, you notice a structure. It is the Palace of the Shadow King. It just kind of looms there, darker than the forest. What do you do? And you should be able to have control of your token, so feel free to move it around or look around or whatever you want to do.
I'm going to go ahead and step out of the pit of bodies.
Okay.
Did I hear the glass break?
Why don't you roll me a presence? DR 12. No, you heard... Well, remember, you can use an omen if you'd like. I don't think a bless will get you there, but you can reroll any die with an omen.
I'll leave it.
Okay. So yeah, you climb your way out of this pit, and there's just flies buzzing around, and yeah, you're in this massive, massive graveyard.
I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna start following these footprints that I see.
Okay. Those footprints are there, yeah. Bloody footprints in the soil. And, you know, as you make your way down, you see a lot of graves. They're empty, though. There's headstones, like I said, just kind of haphazardly placed. They're not in rows, not in any kind of order. There's twisted trees, leafless trees around you. And the graveyard just seems to be going in infinitely, as far as you can tell.
Do the footprints seem fresh, or are they kind of old?
The ones you're on seem relatively fresh. But, you know, once again, you're not quite sure if it's just the damp air keeping the blood wet, or if they are indeed fresh.
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and continue to follow them to the end of this tree where it looks like they stop.
Okay. Do me a favor and roll me another presence. DR 12. Okay. Do you want to bless that or re-roll that or anything? Or are you happy with how it is?
I'll go ahead and bless it.
Okay. So really you just need a one or better. And you got it. So as you're following these tracks, you hear hacking and coughing to your right. And as you look over, you see an old woman on her hands and knees, gasping for breath, below a tree, and she has a noose hanging from her neck.
Who goes there?
She kind of just freezes and looks at him. Yeah. Looks him up and down.
So you see this very interesting looking character. He's very pale, no hair, vaguely humanoid, but he has just an otherness to him. And he does have something strange kind of concealing the front of his face. You can't quite see it from here, but looks like a mask of some kind.
Well, don't just stand there. Help me get this off.
She grabs the noose thing and tries to start worrying the knot.
What is your name?
She...
Harga, what's yours?
Abhor denies the flesh.
That's a mouthful.
Pleased to meet you. And he's going to go ahead and help take the noose off.
Okay. You do so. And while you guys are becoming acquainted, I'm going to move back to Nagel, who is the bottom of this well. And I might as well put you on the map, too. Okay. Even though you are at the bottom of the well.
I'm going to try to climb up again.
All right, roll me another strength. I'm going to give you... I'm going to lower it by 2. Oh, wow, look at that.
Oh, man.
You know what I'm going to do? Because that is a critical success, I'm going to allow that to be to work for double. So you grab hold of these open mouths between the stones, and you work your way up and grab hold of the rope, and barely with the last amount of your strength just climb up, and you're kind of hanging double over the edge of the well. And as you look around, this doesn't look at all like what you remembered. There's just thick fog everywhere. The moonlight is casting like this light, like sour milk almost. And there's twisted trees everywhere, headstones. You don't see the farmstead anywhere. What do you do?
Gonna pull myself out of the well completely.
Okay.
And I guess just kind of walk forward and see what I can find.
Okay, you should have full control of your token, so feel free to move where you want to.
Do I have to click it in any particular way?
You should be able to just click it and then either use the directional keys or move it with a mouse cursor. Can you not select it at all?
Oh, there we go.
There you go.
I guess I'll walk this way to see what this is about.
So yeah, you walk through this graveyard, kind of just picking your way around headstones, and you find yourself at this massive pit. It's dug out of the ground, and it's just full of bodies in various degrees of decay. Flies are just buzzing around it.
Okay.
And the stench is hard to withstand. Feel like you're gonna vomit.
Cover my mouth, but okay. Back away.
All right. Okay.
Yeah.
So you back away. All right. Do you want to do anything else? Otherwise, I'm gonna move on to Nifel.
You can move on to
Nifel. Okay, Nifel. Still find yourself in this crypt, hands still testing that open space there, and still can't get through.
I'm going to... fight a monster again?
No, I'm just trying to see why the fog of war is not working. Like, it should be walls around you where you can just see through the windows. I don't know why you can see the entire map. It's weird.
Yeah, I can see the entire map. Do I have, like, a permission I shouldn't have?
Nah, it's probably something I did in the... But don't worry, go ahead, and I'll worry about it.
Well, I am... My dead god is the Herald of Panic. and in a form of worship, I begin to panic. Okay. I'm going to smash everything in here. If those are urns or vases in the corners, mm-hmm. I'm going to pick them up and smash them. I'm going to take my stake and smash out the rest of these stained glass windows.
Okay. You do
and
so.
And at the peak of this panic attack that I'm having, I'm going to charge at the door and drop a shoulder into it.
Okay, you charge at the door, and you just rebound off it with nothing more than a sore shoulder.
Fuck! What do we do, Arvant? I must get out of here. Can I explore the coffin I was in earlier?
Sure. Yeah, you take a look inside, and you know, it's the top has been, or the lid has been moved off, you know, but inside it looks relatively clean.
There's no secret keys.
Nope. Nothing at all.
And then when I smashed everything in the room, there's nothing. I didn't get any like rupees or anything. No special.
No, but what I would like.
Power ups or potions fell.
What I would like Nagel, Abhor Denies the Flesh, and Harga to do is all roll me a presence check.
Guys.
Who got. Oh, seven. Yeah. So Nagel got a.
My fucking. Please, I was going to say, please get up.
Oh
three.
My god.
You guys all
deaf motherfuckers.
Are you guys going to use an omen at all? Or are you guys going to just
Ooh.
Would you like to succeed at this at all?
I mean,
I know, Cam, I don't need to bane anything so far. This is going great. Sorry, what?
I think we all rolled so low that an omen and a bless would not help.
Well, remember, an omen is re-roll any die. So it's almost like rolling again. It's exactly like rolling again, in fact.
It is
it's like
rolling
advantage.
Again.
Yeah, it's like advantage, exactly.
Wait, deal max damage. Oh, re-roll a die. Yeah.
Totally your choice. You don't have to.
I'll roll again.
All right.
I'm gonna die.
Okay, so you used an omen.
I'm going to, too.
You're going to use one, Janelle? Okay.
Yeah. You said it was presence?
Presence, yes.
I'll use one, too.
You're going to use one, too?
Sure.
7-7. Yeah. Seven, seven.
Wow. Okay.
Cool. Yeah.
Oh.
There we go.
Sorry, I'm updating the sheet. Did someone have a success?
Yes. Yes.
Abhor Denies the Flesh?
Abe.
All right, Abe, as you're speaking to this old woman, you just hear shattering, smashing wood. Sounds like glass, even. You hear cursing. And then you hear muttering. And then you hear nothing at all coming from... behind you in the distance. Doesn't sound too far off.
Sounds like how Mother used to be. We should go check it out.
Yeah. But I'll be right behind you.
Okay. So you guys actually hear it. I will, yeah, that way. See my pointer?
Yeah.
That way. All right. You come to a crypt. There's a metal door on the front. And as you walk up, you do in fact see that the two windows that were on the side closest to you are shattered. But you do see a faint light coming in, you know, coming out one of those windows. Appears to be a torch or a candle or smoldering fire of some kind.
I'm going to go ahead and try the door from the outside.
All right, you try the door and it appears to be locked.
If I go around the side, can I see inside?
Yeah.
The window?
Yeah. Is Fog of War working for you at all? Can you see inside this thing, or do you just see a wall?
I can see inside.
Yeah, it's so weird.
I can see everything.
Okay. All right, so you look through the window, and you see... how do you look, Nifel, other than your pale face and...
At this point, I'm just where I'm at, like, sitting against the wall, like, elbows on my knees, just like, forehead to forehead with Arvant, just, like, hyperventilating.
So that's what you guys see, looking into the window. Or Abe, anyway. Abdif.
I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of stare and kind of cock my head and, let Harga know behind me. There's someone in here.
Why? I'm gonna look at the crypt and try and get an idea of maybe what the purpose of putting someone in there is for.
Well, it appears as most crypts are, you know, for a burial. And I forgot to mention, Abe, are you looking in the window too, Harga, or are you just kind of
I am resting on a tombstone.
You're sitting on a tombstone. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, it looks just like any normal crypt. Very, very old, you know, moss growing over it.
No family name or...
No, there's no... You look around and you don't see any kind of marks at all.
Does it speak?
Are you talking to me?
No, I'm talking to Abe.
It's murmuring to itself. Sad little thing.
Rap on the window. See if it does anything.
Oh. My screen went black.
Oh, it did?
Oh, it's back. Something happened.
Something refreshed.
Can you still see through the walls and everything?
Yes.
Damn it. So yeah, the windows, Harga, you can... I guess he tells you that they're broken, so... Alright, yeah. So while you guys are doing this, let's jump back to... Nagel. So what is Nagel doing now that she stepped away from this pit full of decaying bodies?
Just covering her mouth and goes into her jacket and pulls out this exquisite perfume that she has and sprays it in front of her.
Perfect.
She's like, this is not good. I don't like this. She is going to keep wandering around until she sees possibly people or a crypt.
All right, I'll say, yeah, you wander around a bit and you see what appears to be an old woman sitting on a tombstone looking at a crypt.
Hello.
What is this? I've never seen a graveyard so full of life. What are you doing here?
I don't know. I woke up in well. I managed to get out and I am now here. What are you doing here?
I woke up in a noose. Cut myself down. Not sure. A little worried.
Do I know what time of day it is?
It's hard to tell. It's evening for sure. You can't really tell what time of evening it is. But there's definitely moonlight coming through the thick clouds overhead.
What is this?
There appears to be a person inside. Abhorred the flesh.
What?
Why hear this at this point?
Yeah. So yeah, Nifel, you hear, you know, through the windows and the stone itself, even you hear muttering voices outside.
I'm gonna charge to my feet.
Okay.
Arvant. There is someone here. And I'm going to run to the door and pound on it and just say, I am the prophet of Nost. You will let me out.
You guys hear all of that from within the crypt.
Abe is going to go ahead and look back. There's a prophet in there.
Who is that?
Okay. Hello there.
Harga stands up and goes closer to the door.
Why are you in there?
I'll get the voice eventually.
I don't know. Now let me out.
Is the door sturdily constructed?
Yeah, it appears to be so. It doesn't seem rotted or, you know, rusted away at all, but it is, made of metal.
And the hinges are on the inside or the outside?
You can see the hinges, I'll say. Why not?
I get out my little knife. It's not a very long knife. And just... maybe the middle hinge, I'll see if I can like put it in and try to get the pin out, just kind of like work it out a little bit.
Okay, you sit there and you start doing that for some time. What about everybody else? What does Nagel and Abhorred Denies of Flesh do while Harga is working her knife at the hinges of this door?
So this window's broken, right?
That window, every window you've looked at is broken.
Am I able to reach through it?
You can. So your hands actually go through it. It's conveniently had all broken glass moved aside. Some of it lays on the grass or the soil outside the window. But yeah, you can stick your hands through. And Nifel, you see a pair of hands, very pale hands, coming through the window where his token is.
I will march over to it and grab like onto the wrist of one of the hands.
Okay.
I don't say.
You feel that grab hold?
You will let me out, fool.
Abe is going to go ahead and just kind of look at the hand wrapped around his wrist and just tug as hard as he can. Okay. How big is the opening?
There's small windows. I'd say maybe like, I don't know, a foot and a half by a foot and a half or something like that. Not huge. Okay. So you reach through and you pull the hands, but what's strange is that you kind of have a grip of his wrist, and as you're yanking out, his fingertips bend to fists and his knuckles hit something that doesn't seem to be there. And that's as far as you can pull.
It looks like I won't be the one to get you out.
Can I see him through the window?
Yeah.
I guess that does not tickle. I have a hold of his wrist and he rips out and my hand just like smashes into this
as if it's force. as if it's hitting stone.
And I'll let go when it hits, because okay. I assume my hand just kind of crumples into it. Yeah. And I take Arvas and I like just fuck. Just open the bloody door.
So, you know, Abe, as you're looking in here, you see him cursing and thrashing about, and you see just everything inside has been completely decimated, either, you know, by him or something else. You're not quite sure. But as I said, the only other thing in here is a candle at the back of the room, lit, flickering dimly.
What are these fools doing? Oh, Vaunt, it is not that fucking hard to open a door. I know!
I'm gonna be like just circling the building.
Okay.
Like looking for anything strange or any.
So, yeah, as you round the building, you see even those two windows over there are broken out. Bits of glass on the ground, but as you look at the crypt, it's pretty nondescript. There's no markings whatsoever on the stone that you can see. But yeah, once you reach that rear window, you do see like a candle light spilling across the floor right there. You can't quite see it, but you can see the light. You can't see the candle itself. And, you know, Nifel is just pacing and talking to a skull.
What are you doing here? Were you in there, stuck like the rest of us?
I woke up in this bloody box in this bloody fucking room, and I can't get out.
Is this candle yours?
This is mine. This is mine. I don't know what this is.
You're not helpful.
Neither are you.
All right, everybody, I think this is a good time for a quick break while Nifel curses and is trapped within this crypt. So we will be right back. Give us about five, and thanks for tuning in, everybody. Thanks.
You can stop the apocalypse. We'll be right back. you can stop the apocalypse.
Welcome back, everybody, to Merkburg. We are have just discovered Nagel, Nifel, Abhorred Denies the Flesh, Harga, and they all have had visions of a path where or a past where they have perished. And they've all woken up in places similar or dissimilar to where they last remembered. They've all gathered in this massive graveyard and are trying to free another fellow, Nifel, from this crypt, but nothing they seem to do is working. And that is where we will resume. And I think the fog of war is working, everybody, so I'm going to switch back and forth. Yeah, there we go. That's what I want. Okay, cool. Yeah, disregard this little guy here. That's just for DM vision, so I'm not sharing my screen because I don't want, you know, these guys to peek. So, yeah. This party of four. Please continue.
Have I gotten anywhere?
DM in his mouth. Yeah.
I know, I need to, huh?
Or just, like, shrink him down real small.
Yeah, I guess I can make him tiny.
Regardless, is this candle inside the room with me? Did I not smash it?
You didn't say you smashed it, so I'm assuming you just broke things, but...
Gotcha. But the candle is all that's left. Is it in like a sconce on the wall? Is it just
no,
like
it's actually on the floor. And
it's
just
a candle sitting on the floor.
Just a candle sitting on the floor, and curiously enough, it looks as though the wax is, like, not melting. It's been burning for some time. As far as you know, you have no idea how long it's been burning, but it is still going strong.
Can I pick it up?
Yeah, you pick
how
it up.
How tall is it?
It's yeah. About that big, the way you showed me. It's about a short big. Candle.
Yeah,
it's not very impressive. Yeah. It's red candle.
It's red. Interesting.
I think if that's what I made it put on the map, we'll see.
Is it melty at all?
A little bit, but it's not, it doesn't seem to be, you know, dripping down or reducing in size at all.
Gotcha. I'm gonna
roll for melty.
Stick it on the top of Arvant for right now and just like carry both with me.
Okay. So it doesn't seem to affix itself. So are you going to hold it there, or does he have a hole in his head? Are you going to stick it in like an eye hole or eye socket?
I'm going to jab it into an eye hole.
Okay, that's fine.
And then carry it with me.
All right, so you all see this. Those
fine.
Of you who are... Oh, go ahead, sorry.
Oh, no, I was just talking
okay.
to Arvon.
Talking to Arvon. Perfect. So, yeah, you guys all see this. Those of you who are near a window, you see him pick this candle up. You can just kind of, those of you who aren't, maybe you see some, a little bit of this light go through the windows, but, yeah, there we are.
Am I making any headway with the hinge?
No, the hinge doesn't seem to be really giving. You're kind of scraping off a little bit of rust, but, your dagger or your knife doesn't seem to be the correct tool for the job.
Well, Is there a visible lock on the outdoor, or is it internal?
No, there's nothing you can see, actually. You just see a handle. Don't see a keyhole. Don't see a latch. Don't see anything. So it is kind of peculiar how it remains locked. Because every mechanism you've seen, you know, has some kind of visibility to it. So what's Abhorrid denies the flesh up to right now near that window?
I'm just watching him shove that candle into the skull.
Okay.
Kind of perplexed. How tall is the building?
Let's say it's about 8 feet.
8 feet. If I stretch my hands up, am I able to grab the ledge?
I don't know. How tall are you? Are you about 6 foot? So you can get about a 2 foot reach, maybe?
I'd say so.
Okay. Let's just say that. Why not? Yeah, you can reach the ledge.
I'm going to go ahead and pull myself up and try to get on the roof here.
Okay. Why don't you roll me just a DR8 strength? You going to bless that 7. Or anything? Or? You're one shy.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and bless it.
Okay. Look at all these blesses being used. Thank you, viewers. And thank you, players. I'm glad they're being used.
4.
Perfect. That is enough. So you shamble your way, scramble your way up onto the roof. It's flat.
It's flat. Does it look like there's any portion of it that might be a little weaker? Any cracks?
No, the roof seems as secure as the walls. It's just a little bit more damp here. There's a little bit more moss on the top. But yeah. And Nifel, you hear kind of a rustling sound above you in the stonework.
Can I try to stick the candle out the window?
Sure. You want to try that?
Yeah. Not quickly, just in case it stops.
Yeah, you push it out and it seems as though the candle cannot leave just as your hands. Or as you, I guess. And you notice, though, when you put the candle toward that opening, it flares up a little bit. And you can feel the heat on your face and you kind of recoil a little bit. But then as you retract it back into the room, it normalizes.
Can I just like...
You blow the candle out and you hear a click. But you also hear something else. You hear the sound of sand collecting and scratching over stone. And as you look in the direction of that sound, it's coming toward the door. And it's coming from actually that man shape of soot. And it starts to gain volume and solidify. But it is not the color of sand, it is the color of ash. It is just, or soot and its embers, it's all black. It's like a charred man. And it slowly, all of that soot kind of peels down from the door, retracting into this body as it forms a man in that position. And somebody roll me a d4. Actually, Nifel, roll me a d4. Okay. So you're standing there cursing Arvant, your skull, as this body slowly begins to assemble. And you guys all hear this too, especially Harga. You hear a click on the door. And then you hear, like I mentioned, this sifting like the sand on stone on the other side.
I'll reach for the door handle and see if it turns now.
Yes, it turns.
So I'll pull it towards me.
It opens.
Kind of like peek in.
And inside, you see exactly what you saw through the window. You see Nifel standing there. I guess you still have the candle in the socket, eye socket, yes? Or no, you're holding it?
No, I'm holding it.
You're holding it? Okay. But then Harga, at your feet, you see this soot, like charred. It looks like a charred human body on the ground. And you can see all of the soot dust around it converging onto this shape as it starts to build and build and build. So tell me, Nagel, what is Nagel up to? You see Harga approach the door, open it. What are you up to? Nagel? Can you hear me?
Oh, sorry. Forgot my name. I guess I'll walk over to Harga and try and see what's inside.
Okay.
See this raving, unhelpful man.
You open the door. You guys should be able to see inside.
The door's open, okay.
Yeah, so you look inside and you see Nifel in there with a candle. But at your feet, you see Harga is looking down at this charred body of a man that is slowly building from black dust. Oh, we got a Bane. Thank you, horrible tomato. Much appreciated. So far, I haven't had to use any Banes. They haven't been rolling too hot, but I'm sure my time will come. What about Abhor Denies the Flesh? What is he up to?
So I'm still on the roof.
Oh, that's right. You're on the roof. So yeah, you're here. You hear the door. What you think the door is, click open. Harga approaches. Nagel approaches. Or yeah, I guess you don't know their names yet, but. And that's what you see. You know, they kind of disappear in the front of the building because you can't quite make it out from where you are.
I'm going to go ahead and step down and look through the window.
Okay. You look through the window and you see what I described. There's a charred body of a man in the position on the floor right in front of the door, slowly assembling. But that is all. And it's almost up. Looks like all of the black dust is...
Can I bolt out of this fucking room?
Hell yeah, you can. It's open.
Fuck yeah. I'm bolting out of this goddamn room.
Okay, you bolt out of the room. And just as you make it out the door, the figure stands slowly, doubled over at first, rising to its full height, looking directly at you in the doorway. And it seems to be almost a face you recognize, one of the heretics maybe, or you're just not sure if maybe it's your imagination.
I want to slam the door shut behind me and fuck.
No, go ahead. Get out. Yeah. So this man is standing there.
Yeah, fuck this guy. Heretic.
Well, you want to dash out the door, right?
Oh, I'm already out. I'm,
so
I'm
go ahead, move, yeah, move possible. your token out so I know where everybody is. Yeah.
Yeah, I want to be out and I want to slam the door shut behind me.
Okay, you slam the door shut behind you.
Do I have grappling hook? I cannot start a fire with a grappling hook. I need fire. Do you have fire, old woman?
No.
You.
Other one.
You hear a boom on the door. And it just rattles the entire foundation of this crypt. The door hasn't opened yet.
I need to light the
candle. I have lantern.
What's wrong with you?
Yes. Can I stick the candle into the lantern?
Yes.
Okay. And then can I run to one of the windows and try to stick it back in the room?
Yes, you can do that. So you light the candle.
And does it go through the room?
It does. And the candle drops to the floor, but it stays lit. The fall does not extinguish the flame. And you guys all hear a very audible click. But you continue to hear the banging on the door, and it rattles on its hinges. And you are all outside of this crypt. What do you do? So in all directions you see from where you stand is the graveyard. It goes on endlessly. From where you are right now, you don't see any visible paths. You just see, like I said, a bunch of headstones with no seeming order. Any kind of etchings on them are indecipherable. No names, no symbols, nothing identifiable. But if I didn't already describe this for everybody already, what you do see beyond, above this blanket of fog, is... Oh, we got a raid. Oh, we got a host. Thanks for the host, man. Thought it was a raid almost. You
hosting
see...
Hosting and raiding are like basically the same thing.
Oh, okay. So you see this this dark tree line. And Harga and Nagel, you distinctly know that tree line, and that is the Sarkash Forest. And what you know of this area, you know where you must be, and that is Graven Tosk, the massive cemetery in the center of Sarkash. You've never been here. You've just heard stories.
But I know if or how dangerous it is at night.
Yeah, you've heard that the dead walk here. There are catacombs, and it is seemingly endless.
Well, it would be good to find a more secure location to...
Yes, let's get the fuck out of here!
And she...
Yeah, you guys have... So as you guys, you know, collect yourselves and, you know, catch your breaths from this near encounter, all of you hear this voice inside your head. It sounds like your own. It sounds like your own thoughts, but it also doesn't. And Nagel, you hear, you cannot escape this place. Nifel hears, the earth, the stones, the dead, they grow warmer. Abhor denies the flesh hears, the mist, it plays tricks on your mind. And finally, Harkaw hears, the graveyard is full, no other dead shall be brought. And you stand outside in the ghostly fog. What do you do? And like I said, you guys have all full control of your tokens, so feel free to wander about. And you guys do know, actually, Nifel and Nagel, you're standing right there. You see bloody footprints leading to the crypt door, leading away from the crypt door. But their location is concealed by the fog, or where they go to. Just disappears into it.
I have a lantern, so I guess I could probably see them.
Yeah, if you want to, if you right click your token, I'll show you. Mm-hmm. It should pop up with a menu, and there is actually a lantern. You see it?
Yeah, I just lit it.
There's your lantern. Okay. So yeah, the illumination, you can see it quite clearly now. But once again, the fog kind of covers up, you know, it pretty much swallows that. So you kind of have to keep moving to track it if you want to.
Okay, yeah. Kind of without saying anything, I'm just going to put the lantern like down, hold it down, like kind of follow the footsteps a little.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead and move you. You guys all have free control of your tokens.
I'll follow after it, but I'll like puff up and like pull my arms out with Arvant with me, and it says, "My God has spoken to me. I don't know what he means, but he has spoken. There is warmth here."
Did he tell you the graveyard is full?
No, he said. What did he say again? Something about warmth in bodies.
He said the graveyard grows warmer.
It's warm here.
Doesn't feel warm to you, but that's what you heard, yeah.
If he said it, it's true.
It feels cold to me.
Mm. Who are you?
Me?
All of you.
I'm Nagel.
Arga.
Bord denies the flesh, but you can call me Abe.
What are we doing here?
Who are you?
I am Nifel. The prophet of Nost, herald of panic.
Oh, okay. Have you seen these footprints?
Well, I see them now. Maybe we should follow them away from whatever is still banging on the door.
Does Harga think she died, given her little message in her head?
You don't know. Like I said, you had the last thing you remember is killing your nephew, strangling him to death, and then being rounded up by a bunch of the nearby town folk and hanged. And then you woke up here.
I see any new graves?
It's hard to tell. They all look about the same age. Yeah, nothing looks... I mean, apart from the ones that are... there are a few, like on the map, you can see that they've been dug, but it doesn't seem super fresh. Just like
I'll
if someone...
Along.
You're going to follow along? Okay.
Okay.
So... Are you guys just going to follow these tracks?
Okay. So.
Okay, you guys follow these tracks and you come to Nagel. You smell it before you see it because you remember it. Abe as well. There is this massive pit of bodies. Various levels of decay. And it is just huge. None of them, thankfully, are stirring.
I'm going to spray them.
Spray them with perfume?
Yeah.
Okay. Why don't you guys all roll me a presence, 12. Look at that. Oh, a 1. A 0. So, who succeeded? Hargha, Abhor denies the flesh. Nifel, you got a 0. And then Nagel got an 8. So Abhor, Abe, and Harga, you see kind of a glitter in the among the bodies. Some of these bodies, they're not completely stripped of clothing. They have armor pouches, things like that. As you creep toward the edge, you can see that they all have not been completely picked clean of the belongings they had while they lived.
How deep is the pit?
It's probably about 6 feet. But it's full. I mean, you could walk through this if you wanted to.
She'll get down on her derriere.
Okay.
And scooch forward.
All right.
And just
you want to get inside?
She's going to start looking through for anything useful.
Okay. So what I want you to do.
Especially if there's cool fungus.
Roll me a d6. So, within one of these corpses, you find a pouch, and in that pouch, you find, and roll me 3d10. You find 13 silver pieces.
I'll pocket it.
And, Abhor denies the flesh, so all of you guys see her kind of sifting through the dead, and you see a little glint of familiar silver in the moonlight in her hand. Does anyone else like to search?
Yeah, especially when you said there was like some armor or things like that in there.
Well, like, why don't everybody roll me a d6? Other than Harga, because you already did. So we got, what do we got here? So Abhor denies the flesh, you get a 3. So you start digging around and you find something around a woman's neck. And it's a pendant. And you pluck it free and you open it. And inside, you see a portrait. It's kind of etched. And it's of a man, but strangely, there is no mouth. There's everything else, and it's rendered in expert detail for the size. And Nagel rolled a 5. So you find a rope, and you keep pulling and pulling and pulling. And at the other end is a noose, and attached to that noose is a head. And Nifel, you find the same thing, strangely enough. So you look over at Nagel and share a glance that you guys have both found 10 feet of rope with a noose at one end. And whether or not you'd like to keep the head is up to you.
I don't have enough room. Throw it back.
So as you guys are standing here looking at the edge, looking beyond, you notice that it's almost like this trough that keeps going. So it's a circular pit, but at the end, directly opposite you, it's like a foxhole, like a canal that just keeps going off into the distance. And in that distance, at the very end of it, you think you see an archway made of stone.
The shiny thing that I saw, have I investigated it? Is that what I found?
Oh, sorry. You found the silver. Is okay. That what you mean? Yeah.
The shiny thing.
Yeah, you found the silver. Yep.
Okay.
So you all see this. You all see this, carved out area about the same depth of the pit. but it's and you can see that the body parts kind of diminishing as it gets farther away from you.
Does everyone see that? And she points.
Do I have any idea what that might be for?
What?
The trough.
No, it's just like a... It's as if someone dug a big circular hole and then digged a path out of it, leading the opposite direction. So it's like what you see on the map. So you could jump down into it and walk, follow along if you want to. And like I said, at the very end of it is a stone archway, and it's kind of, it almost looks like a pile of rubble, but you can definitely see that this pathway goes into darkness.
She'll try and climb back out.
Okay, you do. Off, you do.
And start slowly walking around.
Okay.
Towards.
What about everybody else? Is everybody following her? Or are you guys doing something else? Still investigating the pit?
I'll follow.
Okay.
Yeah.
So as you guys get close, you see what I described in more detail. The soil is very rich and dark at the bottom. But there are a few body parts kind of strewn about, but in no way, shape, or form at the, you know, the compared to the mass of flesh that is in the circular pit. And yeah, upon getting closer, you can see that this leads into a stone archway down into the ground.
I'm probably going to not enjoy it, but I'm going to give a good sniff.
It's soil, it's stone, it's stale. Nothing other than that. I mean, even from here, the scent of rot seems to be diminished somewhat.
There's no breeze or anything coming out of it?
Not that you can tell, no. Like I said, you have this really soupy fog everywhere, so doesn't seem to be like moving away from that area at all. If anything, it's like tendrils of it are just going and disappearing into the darkness.
Might be safer in there. Might not. What do you say?
What is your plan here, old woman?
To find a place where I will not be eaten while I sleep. Beyond that, not much.
Are you a believer in the Herald of Panic?
The who?
Nost, the Herald of Panic.
Have I ever heard of him? Is he like an established deity, or?
Why don't you roll me a presence check? But I want it to be like a DR 16. Okay, you've never heard of Nost unless you would like to use an omen to reroll or something like that.
Use for gods.
The only people or the only things you know that are worshipped are he and she, the two basilisks. He living in the Bergen Crypt, born of she. There are dead gods, there are folk gods, there are cults rising up all the time. So you just surmise that Nost is another one of those. Go ahead.
Continue on.
Okay.
Slowly down, kind of.
Are you getting into? Are you sliding down into the depression?
I wave the person with the light ahead.
All right, I'll go.
Did you keep that stake, Nifel? That you found, the wooden stake?
I did. Okay. Yeah, I added it to my.
Okay. Cool.
Pack. Can I? Do I? I just added it as a miscellaneous. Do I get anything with the stake?
I will say it's like a D4 damage if you want to use it as a weapon. Okay, you guys get closer and closer, and it just becomes darker and darker and darker. Do you enter?
Probably.
Yeah. Okay. You guys descend into the darkness through the archway. All right, give me 1 second. I need to load another map.
Also, real quick, I have a needle, too.
Hook a needle, huh?
Yeah, I have a sharp needle. Could I get like a D1 for that, or like a D2?
A sharp, like a just a little sewing needle?
I have no idea. I just in my rolls, I acquired a sharp needle.
Yeah, I'll just say that's a D4. Why not?
So it's the same as my short sword, the needle.
Yeah, let's just say it's like a, let's say it's a large needle, like a large knitting needle or something. Unless you want it to be a small needle, I'll leave it up to you. If you want it to be
something
that may like pick locks or something, it's up to you.
Ooh, yeah. Let's keep it as a lock pick. I got a stake in a short sword. I'll keep it as kind of like a lock picky thing.
Okay. All right. So
I want it to be like a thick short needle though. Like the thing's got a little bit of something to it. It's not just like a little baby.
All right. So let me know when you guys see your tokens.
Yep.
You see them?
I see me.
All right. So Nagel, you may want to turn your lantern back on.
Oh, I didn't mean to turn it off.
I think it probably auto turned off.
Oh, okay.
There you go. So you guys find yourself in a cave-like structure. It's been dug out, but the walls are unfinished. It's very natural, but you do see on the ground, you see on the floor, it actually... there appears to be some stones, some masonry on the floor, as if this place is unfinished. And ahead is just darkness and twisting cavern. Thick. Wow. Well, that's a lot of seas, man. A lot of seas.
So many seas.
So do you guys follow her?
Well, if this is the way it is right now, and I'm a little bit back with Abhor denies the flesh.
Yeah, you guys can choose the order however you want.
Yeah.
So, Nagel, if you want to take the lead, up to you. You do have a light,
What was your name, boy?
You can call me Abe.
Abe, what is on your face?
It is my home. My birthplace.
But what fuck is it? No, stop it. Stop it. Are you a believer of Nost?
I'm a believer of the inevitable.
Close enough. All right.
Abe's gonna go ahead and use his power of false dawn to give us a little bit of light.
Wow, okay. So how long is that again? How many minutes is that?
3d10.
Wow, okay. So let me change your vision, actually. So roll me a 3d10.
Ooh.
So for 26, that's really good, man.
Holy so shit, did you just roll 27 out of 30?
Yeah, 26. So I'm going to give you, actually that's everybody, right? Because it casts brightness.
Yes.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is... I'm give everybody extended vision here. So let's see, bright vision up to, I don't know, how far could somebody see? 120, maybe?
You think? Probably. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Let's go with that. All right, I'm going to give you, you guys should all see your vision updating pretty soon here. Hopefully, let me know if you don't.
What is that? Because I'm still kind of like chatting at this guy. What did that look like?
Sorry, you're what?
Oh, we are being raided.
Oh, hello, raid. Welcome, welcome. We are playing Merkborg. Hopefully, if you're raiding us, you've heard of that game. It's an amazing Swedish game. Put out by Johan Nor and Pelle Nielsen. Published by Free League. And this is actually session one of Graves Left Wanting. And the characters have now woken. They had somewhat of a flashback or a memory of being killed, all of them. And they've all woken in different parts of this seemingly endless graveyard. Nagel was, she woke at the bottom of a well and had to climb her way out through walls that had mouths themselves. Nifel. Wow. Thank you guys, everybody, for the following. Much appreciated. Wow. Look at all these. Thank you so much, everybody. Nifel.
And as you follow, real quick, sorry, we are doing, especially if you've heard of Morkborg, we are doing a giveaway for the Morkborg book. So make sure to exclamation point giveaway if you're going to stick around and want to win that as well.
Yes. This beautiful book right here, will it work? Janelle can always get to work. If you never even play the game, it's an amazing book to own on your have on your shelf. So, all right, as we continue, our four lost souls have delved into a catacomb that led out of a plague pit, a literal plague pit full of decomposing bodies. Wow, thank you everybody for the follows. Welcome, welcome. And they are looking into this catacomb. One of them, Abhor Denies the Flesh, has cast a power. Thank you so much, everybody. Which is giving them light for 26 minutes. Let's see how long that light will last. If they continue to stand here.
Harga is going to heft down her sack and rifle through it a little bit and pull out one of her filters.
Okay.
Pop. Kind of wipe off her hand and pour it into her hand and just...
Wipe it on your face?
Directly in the eyeballs.
So what does it look like? What is this concoction you have, this fluid?
I'd say it's a milky white.
It's milky white, okay.
It probably...
Viscous or like watery or what?
It's an oil.
Okay.
So it leaves a bit of a sheen all over her face as she puts it in.
And what does this oil do? What does it make Harga feel?
She blinks or see? And it allows her to have +2 on presence tests for D4 hours.
Okay, so roll me a D4.
Okay, so for 2 hours.
2 hours. You will have, just remind me when you roll presence, okay?
Yep.
Cool. So as I said, the fog from the graveyard spills into this cavern, but you can see as far as you can in daylight thanks to Abhorred Denies the Flesh's gift. So yeah, you guys all wonder where this light came from. I don't believe he said he was doing anything, but there you are. And it's deathly quiet. You don't hear anything except your own breathing.
I was talking to him when this happened. Did I see you do anything, Shelly?
Yeah, so you see him kind of just grab a a handful of soil and just kind of squeeze it until kind of just all of the color runs out of it. Like he took the nutrients from the soil and then light.
Awesome.
Was that you, boy?
I believe it was. I didn't know I could do that.
You will be an asset for the Herald of Panic. Yes, Avant.
Well,
okay.
Let's go.
Yeah, you hear Nifel having this conversation with Abe behind you, and Nagel, you seem to not need your lantern anymore, so you think you may want to preserve the oil.
Okay, I'll turn it off.
Okay. So the cavern ahead, yeah, seems to, you know, twist, wind its way. But as you guys go deeper inside, you do notice more patches of stonework, more masonry, more finished flooring here. You know, among the black, you know, dirt and soil from the walls. Although it looks like it hasn't really been walked on for a long, long time, as far as you can tell.
My vision's not updating.
Oh, sorry. Maybe I forgot you. Sorry, I did.
Everything was dark.
How about that?
Perfect.
All right. So you guys should all be able to see. So yeah, you continue to make your way down.
So deep. Okay.
So yeah, as you guys round this corner, you start to see the same flooring you noticed a little bit past the cave, and it seems to get more and more completed the farther you get inside. But as I said, that same fog just permeates everything. It doesn't seem to diminish, dissipate, anything like that. It's just everywhere. And the air here, though, is warm. It's warmer than it was outside, and Nifel, that kind of strikes you. You hear that voice, your own voice in your head again, about the graveyard being warmer as you step around this corner and you feel just that heat come down the cavern.
Yes, Avant, our god was right. It is warm.
So in here, you see, as you guys stand, Nagel especially, you guys are kind of just looking around your shoulder. But you can see that the walls here are finished. They're old, but they're finished. And there's a lot, you know, you can see, just like I said, the floor is all these flagstones. But you don't see any prints. You don't see any sign of people walking about. But at the other end, you do see, and this brilliant light that Abe has created for you, is a sarcophagus. And it is standing upright, though. I did not have the graphic for an upright sarcophagus, so it is not laying flat. But it is upright, completely sealed. And on either side of it are two sconces, or a sconce each, but they are unlit. And there's no ornamentation, no names, no etchings or anything on this stone sarcophagus. And then off to the right, as you stand here, Nagel, you see another passageway leading to the north and one leading to the south, it appears.
Okay.
What do you do?
I think at this point, since I appear to be leading this group, I am going to use my hermetic step.
Okay. So tell us all what the hermetic step does, the power of the esoteric hermit.
It allows me to find traps in my path for 2d10 minutes.
Okay, so why don't you roll me a 2d10?
Okay.
And everybody keep track of how many powers you can use per day as well.
Oh.
Wow, there. Look at that roll. So for 20 minutes. So just a little bit longer, or a little bit shorter, I should say, than Abe's light.
Okay.
Holy crap.
So where you're standing, what's up?
Yep. Nope. What were you saying?
Nifel, were you saying something?
I just said, holy crap. In the last 5d10 rolls, it equaled a total of what, like 47?
Yeah, I know you guys are rolling like crap on the checks, but then great on the duration or whatever it may be. So yeah, as I said, you guys walk into this open chamber. Walls are all made of, you know, mason stone, and there's a sarcophagus, a large sarcophagus at the opposite end. And on either side are sconces. Blackened metal. And there is I will just use my little fancy pointer. Up here, you see I guess I gotta move my token out here so everybody on the chat can see. So there's a passageway up here. And up here, or down there. And yeah, sarcophagus.
So I'm feeling a little bit more confident. So
okay.
I'm gonna walk forward and check this thing out.
Okay. As you walk forward, your heightened senses do not feel anything out of the ordinary. So yeah, you get up there, you move toward the sarcophagus, and even upon closer inspection, there's no writing, no nothing, no symbols, no sign of anyone trying to ever get in. But it is large, it is made of stone, and it is upright, meaning the lid would fall forward if you tried to open it, essentially. You can't, it's not laying flat like this.
Okay.
Oh, thank you for the bane, Eric. My man, I will update that. I need to start using... I haven't had to use these yet, though. You guys have been rolling like shit on the 20s, but... The game is young. So what would you guys like to do?
Well, I will not be fucking with any more candles today, that's for sure.
Argo goes over and takes just a peek down the northern corridor.
Okay. You see that the stonework here kind of devolves back to the cavernous walls. So you can see a blend of the finished walls, kind of just, like I said, this place seems like just certain parts of it were worked on. And then for some reason, uncompleted. So.
That doesn't look comfortable.
Just light the sconces is what could go wrong. I like that.
Can I investigate the sarcophagus more?
Of course you can. So you don't see anything, really. I mean, it's clean. There's no sign of anyone trying to get in. No chisels or crowbars or marks like that on the edges where the seal is. But yeah, nothing out of the ordinary.
Can I attempt to open it?
Sure.
I'm gonna step away because I'm very.
Is anyone
worried.
Going to help him or?
Oh,
you
want
to just do it? So I will tell you right now, from a rules standpoint, how this is gonna work. It is a difficulty rating 18. But then for every person who attempts it to help, it goes down by 2.
Okay. Abe will help.
I would also like to use one of my omens.
Thanks,
to
Eric.
Reduce the DR by an additional -4.
Okay, so who is all? Is just Abe helping? So it's Abe and Nifel. So it'd be a 16 minus another 4, so a 12.
Yeah, so okay. 12. On strength.
All right, let me. Yeah, it's a strength test, and I will remove one of your omens. You haven't used an omen yet. Wow.
No, I'm just down to 3, right?
Yeah, you are down to 3. I'm updating it right now.
Which is my starting.
Correct.
Okay.
Because of Mr. L2, the generous man he is. Oh, wow. Okay, Marison, thank you.
I think topping off Jess and Janelle. Hey, thank you so much for the bids.
Thank you.
Wow.
I only have a max of 2.
1,000? So what did we get? We got...
That's way is that a... above.
Yeah.
You just like...
What are we getting? Are we getting everybody's stuff? Dropping omens.
So Marison, the XP is channel points and the bits is bits. So it's only 100. So it's... No, he's right.
He's doing omens.
Oh, he's doing omens.
So 2 omens for Jess and 2 for Janelle. So he's going to top up Janelle and put Jess at 3. You are the man. Thank you so much, Marison.
But I can only have 2.
Yeah, just so you know, we did definitely give everybody their omens, but we cannot allow them to go over their maximum, meaning that that rightmost number, because the game has a cap on that.
I'm not omen-y.
So that could, well, it's still 4. So if Janelle could top up, and then Jess could top up.
Oh, Jess could top up too? So okay, works, 4 yeah. or 4.
Cool. 1 for
okay.
Janelle and 3 for Jess. And then they'll be all topped up. And we'll all be topped up, but Ducky will just be down 1. Abe, Shelly. Boy.
You guys got the omens. All right, we should be updated on the screen, everybody. Thank you so much, Marison, again. That's awesome. Appreciate it. So yeah, you, Nifel, and Abe are attempting to remove the lid of the sarcophagus. So I believe that was a 12, right? Did you roll a 20?
I don't think I rolled it. Did I?
Okay, I just. Oh, never mind. That's 2d10. Sorry, that's Nagel.
Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, roll me a strength test. Oh, there you go.
Nice.
All right, with the sound of stone on stone, the lid begins to part away from the back of the sarcophagus. And a warm air spills out, warmer than the air that is in this room. And inside, you see a man's corpse. Strangely, though, there is no smell. And he's wearing fine silk clothes. And as you look at his flesh, it appears to be very waxy in texture. You haven't reached out to touch it yet, so you can tell me if you want to touch it. But it's not decayed. It's not dried out. It almost looks like the wax of a candle. The very candle you had back in the crypt.
Damn candle. I know, Arvant, I know.
Can you describe that to me one more time?
Sure, of course. So inside there's a man's corpse. He's finely dressed. All of his garb is silk. It looks just completely unblemished. But what's really strange about this is that there is no smell of rot, of decay, or anything like that. Because that smell seems to permeate this entire place. But his skin is waxy. Like I said, it almost looks like the wax of the candle that you found in the crypt.
So it's red.
No, not the color, I'm sorry. But the consistency, the look of the...
Consistency. Gotcha, correct. gotcha.
Oh, wait. Did somebody catch... Was that an old one?
Yeah. No, Eric topped Ducky off.
Thanks, Eric. All right, let me update that. So,
yeah, and we can start using our own channel points. I got like 25k.
Yeah, yeah. So. Eric's like, dude, I'm getting rid of it all.
Same.
Okay. All right. So yeah, you guys are all, and all of you see this. You guys are all within eyeshot of this thing, of this man.
What have you done?
Are his eyes open or closed?
They are closed. Actually, I'm gonna change up the tunes too. I gotta.
Can I poke him?
No! I don't like.
You're gonna poke him? With what?
I'm gonna pull out the stake.
Okay, you take out the stake.
And I'm gonna poke him with a not pointy end. I'm just gonna poke him.
Nothing happens.
Right in the cheekbone. Just. What does it feel like when I poke him?
So when you poke it, it feels just almost lifelike. You know? Like,
so is this like a Madame Tussaud situation here, or is it like?
I mean, it feels there is some give to it. It doesn't seem to break the flesh, though. Doesn't move. There's no response. There's no. It doesn't jump out and grab you. Doesn't.
I want to rifle through his nice clothes.
Okay. You start to rifle through his clothes. You strip it away to his bare chest. And where his ribs are, you see a hint of, it looks almost like metal. Like the skin has separated slightly from that bone. It looks like solid iron.
We need to explore this more. Let me get these clothes off of him. He's about my size.
Oh, I like where you're going with this. You can be a fine dressed dead god's prophet.
Boy, help me with this.
Harga is going to look inside the sarcophagus as they pulled the body out.
Okay, just, you guys are you guys just removing the clothes, or are you trying to pull him out completely?
I just wanted to kind of take as much off as I could with him still in the box.
Yeah, you can pretty much remove all of it. There's no resistance with his legs or his arms. You're able to unbutton his shirt, strip it away from him. Yeah, and so he's completely nude. Like I said, the flesh everywhere looks the same except for that spot. All of you see this. On his rib, there's an exposed piece of just where his rib bone would be. And it looks to be made of solid iron. Yeah. 20 for nude?
Yeah.
We're good.
Hey, Mama Guac.
I immediately put all that in my backpack. Is that an item? Should I just put like fine clothes or something?
Yeah. Of course. Yeah, you can take his clothes. That would count as one item in your inventory. Yep. Yeah. And those can look however you want. They're just finely tailored silk clothes.
So here's the thing. So this kind of will just explain one of my gifts. I don't have any powers. Is that a thing, right? I just have gifts, but I don't have any powers.
Correct. Unless you were to find a scroll, which would give you a power.
Correct. Just so anything, I'm the Lord of Nothing. And I wear a bizarre arrangement of garments and scraps that make me look like the parody of a king or a queen. But I gain +2 rolls to impress the evilly fooled. So could I just basically say, like, this is how I, like, start with that power a little
bit?
Sure,
that's awesome.
Fine clothes that kind of that dolls it up.
That's awesome. I love that. Okay. Yeah.
So I'll slip that into, like, kind of underneath my robes and things. And not all of it, just the pieces I think look good. So it just adds to this kind of, like, hodgepodge of randomly nice garments. But they're nice, right?
They're very nice. However you want, whatever color you want them to be. They're just made of silk.
All right. All right. That's all I'm focused on for right now. I don't care about
this. Okay. So what about the rest of you? So you see that, you know, Nifel is just completely enamored with these fine clothes, and he's balling them up. You said you're putting them under your robes, right? Putting them on?
I'm just starting to put, like, move some stuff out of the way, toss some things. Okay. I'm just getting into the clothes. Like, I could give two shits.
This man's nude corpse is just standing upright, arms at his sides. He's a little kind of, you know, twisted around because Nifel was stripping him clean. But the only thing is, like, his skin from head to toe, waxy flesh. He has hair still. Eyes are closed. Bit of exposed metal where his rib bone is. That's all you notice. And as I said, in this room, you look around, there is a passage going north and a passage going south.
Arga is going to reach up and lift the eyelid.
Okay. You lift it up and there is an eye looking directly back at you. But that eye is chrome, so it's almost you looking back at yourself distorted.
That's not useful at all. Let it go. Go towards the southern.
Hey, it could be good to like trip some people chasing you. I don't know. So you're going to do what?
Giant, like inch wide ball.
Or hey, doesn't Abhorred has a sling, right?
I was going to say, yeah.
Yeah, you're close enough. I mean, you see her like lift the eyelid and there's this just unblemished, like perfect chrome sphere in his eyeball, or where his eyeball should be.
I'm gonna go ahead, yeah, and pop out the eyeball. He's met the inevitable.
Okay, so when you pop out that eyeball, you see the eye socket, and it too appears to be made of the same iron that is exposed where the rib is.
Nifal, come here. Look at this.
One his, boy.
His bones, they are made of metal. What does your god tell you about this?
What about the other one?
Can I check the other eye?
Sure, you do. You find the same thing. It is a chrome orb, much like the first one.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and pop that one out too.
You pop that one out and, you know, you're observing him do this, Nifal, and you see clearly that the eye socket, the inside of the skull, is the same iron material as what you see on the rib. And then as you let go, his eyes
are your first eyeballs.
But yeah, nothing seems to happen.
And there's just an exposed area of iron on his chest?
So it's just where one rib is, his upper right rib. You see a bit of the flesh has somehow been, you know, tampered with and a hole has been made. And so it's exposed. Yeah.
On the right side, not the left side.
The right side.
Not like heart area. It's just like right. Okay.
Well, now I want to know what the inside looked like. Does anyone have a dagger?
You may borrow it. She'll hand it over. Yes, that's first.
That's fine, old woman. And I take it from her grasp.
Okay.
And I'm just gonna, like, put Arvant down.
Mm-hmm.
Like on the edge of the sarcophagus, kind of like watching what I'm doing. It's fine. It'll be fine. I'm going to take the dagger and I just want to stab it in right below the sternum.
Okay.
You know what? No. Let's go full autopsy here. And I'm going to start with a Y cut from the corners till it meets in the chest.
Okay.
And then I'm going to open all the way down, past and around the belly button.
You open it, and those flaps of skin seem to peel back of their own accord. And you kind of step back a bit, startled, and you see that inside, the skeleton is completely made of iron, just like that exposed rib, just like that eye socket. But then you also see something deeper in the center of the rib cage. And it glimmers red, like a very rich crimson. But it's still kind of, you know, concealed by the rib cage and the shadows and things like that. So,
gotcha. And what about? So I'm going to take this cut all the way down to the to the business.
Okay.
And when I peel back the guts, like the stomach area, what is inside there?
Completely empty. The only thing of substance underneath the skin is the skeleton itself, completely made of iron.
Can I reach up under the rib cage through that empty abdominal cavity and grasp whatever this red thing is?
Yeah, you reach inside, you grasp this thing, and it's cut like a gem. And it's cold.
I wanna. It's fine, Arvant. I wanna pull it out of the chest.
Okay, you pull it out of the chest and you hold it before you, and it's a fist-sized red gem. You've never seen anything like this before. It's expertly cut, could probably fetch quite a bit of silver in a city.
This will fill the coffers for my guard quite well.
But yeah, that's... So you guys all see Nifel standing there admiring this massive gemstone. Standing before this corpse that has been split open from collarbone to cock, I guess. And inside you all see this massive iron skeleton, and there is no innards, no movement, nothing.
Something family jewels.
Was it like a ruby?
It's just exactly. It's just a big red rock gemstone.
What should I call it from inventory? Just massive ruby?
Yeah, just call it fist-sized ruby. Fist-sized ruby. That's good.
Fist ruby.
So anyway, nothing. You didn't awaken any creatures that you know of. Nothing. You're standing there all looking at each other, wondering how could you have possibly taken out this treasure without disturbing a soul. But you don't. And you stand in this very quiet, very empty room.
Have I seen Nagel's femur?
I don't know, Nagel, have you had your femur exposed to Nifel?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
All right. Never mind. I was going to say, we could replace it with a metal one, see if that bumps you up on the femur scale. But if I haven't seen it, then I'm... Yes.
Well... What now?
I'll retrieve my knife. Put it away. Just kind of hold it in my hand as I go towards the southern corridor.
Okay. You peek into the southern corridor. And again, it looks very finished, just like the room you're in. It kind of angles off to the west.
Well, this one is at least finished. We should take a peek. What do you say?
Yes, I'd like to get out of here as soon as possible.
So yeah, you guys have free control of your token, so feel free to move where you want, and I'll assume the order is, you know, where you guys are.
Oh. Let's go. So with the current order, with Nagel kind of hanging to the back now.
Okay.
I'm going to kind of give my pitch again.
So, girl, what are your thoughts on Nost? Are you a believer?
I don't know of Nost.
I can teach you.
So as you guys round this corridor, there's an immensely long hallway. And you do see in these alcoves, they seem to go all the way down as far as you can see. And once again, There's a lot of haze, a lot of fog in here. So you can't see very far, but it's a series of statues. And they're all standing in these alcoves. They're all cloaked. They're all looking down at something they have grasped in two hands. And that something is a cross upside down, which you know very well as the symbol of the two-headed basilisk.
No. No, 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 no. It is she that killed my god at the peak of the Bergen Crypt.
Not very useful then, huh? And sure.
So I want you guys, who's the lead? Harga? Oh, sorry, go ahead. Tell me what you're going to do.
Harga takes a step forward and just kind of like stands in front, or begins to stand in front of one of them and just give it a real good look.
Okay. You inspect further, and you see at the top of this cross is an eye. And it is extremely lifelike. You haven't touched it yet, but it looks wet and alive, and it looks to be looking right at you. And I think that's where we're going to end the session, everybody. It is 10 p.m. No? Thanks so much for joining us for session one of Merkborg, running the adventure Graves Left Wanting. Thanks so much to Jess, Ryan, Ducky, Janelle. They've all been fucking awesome. I'm loving it. What else do we got? We got some announcements. Let's do some shout outs. Let's shout out Melee himself, the man here. He can shout himself out. Ducky, Janelle, everybody who streams, who shares content. And then TGT, I know they stopped by. I'm not sure if they're here anymore, but the usual list. And I think it's about time, once we get this wrapped up, for a giveaway.
It is about time for a giveaway. So yeah, anyone watching, if you haven't seen it popping up over and over again, you got about 30 seconds to enter the giveaway. If you would like to win a copy of the Merkborg book, as soon as I get it pulled up, we will go ahead and do that. I know I missed some of the shout outs. I know there's a lot of other people in here. Could we also get a shout out for Heltinde? I know that she's in here as well. There you go, Ginger. So
hopefully I spelled that right. I don't know. No, I didn't.
Is that for Heltinde?
Yeah. Sorry.
We got it. And yeah, we a bunch of us rock the Merkborg shirt. So, okay, so we are wrapping it. Let's remember. I'm closing it in 3, 2, 1.
Who is the winner? Who is the winner?
So the winner is Jedi Mama.
All right.
Mother of Jedi.
Nice. Congrats.
So we will be sending you a copy of the Merkborg book, just as soon as I think Andy has the actual giveaway copy, or did he give it to you already, Jason?
He did not give it to me.
So as soon as we get that copy from Evil Andy, we will get that in the mail. So Jedi Mama, if you want to shoot me a message when you get a chance, and we will coordinate that, getting that sent out to you. Thank you guys all so much for entering the giveaway. Thank you for being here. Really appreciate it. This was so much fun. Make sure to catch us on, I believe next week we'll still be taking a break from Theros, and we'll be starting the next arc for that shortly thereafter. But if you like Magic the Gathering and the Mythic Odysseys of Theros setting, check us out on Mondays as soon as that picks back up. On Wednesdays, most of the people in here
half the people in here besides me are in our Dark Kingdoms campaign, including Senior Daedalus in the chat. So come check us out for our It's an Evil campaign. I feel like this one kind of takes a cake for the more evil one now.
Well, I mean, you guys haven't been technically evil, yeah, right? Yet. We'll see.
Right? No, it's a more evil. So we're evil in a not very evil world in Midgard. And here we're surviving in a very, very evil world. Yes. Less toe jokes.
Yeah, surprisingly.
So far.
Yeah.
Even with a corpse, with waxy toes. You guys, no, you
with
guys.
Waxy toes. Yeah. No, more worried about the other stuff. If you.
But anyway, one. Else, yeah, I just wanted to say once again, look for a raid if you can. The fantastic guys over at Heimat der Katastrophe. I'll drop the link in the chat. They allowed us to use the Merkborg soundtrack that Noel composed. Oh. They have an amazing, massive selection of dungeon synths. So if you like what you hear here, go check it out.
Fix that real quick. I'll help you out with that.
Okay.
So if you just put in !Noel from now on, that will be the shout out for the music. And then what's our category right now?
TTRPGs.
It's just called TTRPG.
Yeah, TTRPGs, tabletop role playing games.
Can't find TTRPG as a category.
What about with an S at the end? TTRPG, RPGs.
Table tennis, multi-table tournament.
Well, shit.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Maybe you got to look up tabletop. Look up tabletop RPGs because that's what ours is listed under. Maybe that's it. Like type
tabletop
the whole thing
RPGs. Yes. Yeah. Open link in new tab.
There we go, Cam.
There we go.
Cam's got it.
We got it here. We are the number one channel on tabletop RPGs
Heck
right now.
Yeah, that's what we want.
Thank you all so much for being here. Can we get another shout out? Can you check the, let me check in the creator dashboard. I just want to make sure. I believe it was Vorpal Tales for that big raid that came in about halfway through.
Okay. But yeah,
everybody. Thank you so much for being here. And yeah. Thank you everyone that stuck around.
Yeah, I hope you guys Vorpal enjoyed Tales. It. We will be back here next Thursday to see exactly what this weird eyeball is that's staring right at Hagra from this statue is doing. So yeah, had a good time. Hope everyone had a great time. And yeah, did you find the who we want to raid yet? Nobody?
I found one, but then I jumped in and they are not currently speaking English. Let's just pick. I don't see any Morkborg anywhere. And there's
We could probably just do it.
There's a lot of Spanish channels going on right now. Almost all of them are. So yeah, let's just hop into D&D.
Thanks, Amarisa. All right, and yeah, stick around. We have a thank you screen to thank all of you amazing people who donated. Top these guys off like crazy. I'm really going to have to start using my Banes because, yeah, maybe a little OP. We'll see. I don't know. Janelle's shaking her head. But yeah, they will be delving further into the catacombs in the graveyard of Greventosk to see if they can find out why they're here or maybe how to escape even.
All right. Okay. So I have the person we're gonna hop into. So thank you all so much for being here. Like Jason just said, just stick around. We're gonna thank everyone again in the community with our credits as we gather the raid, and then we will we'll move on out. So again, catch us on probably not this Monday, catch us on Wednesday, and catch us back here again next Thursday. And everyone have a wonderful evening. Thank you
Great.
So much for being here.
Thanks everybody. Bye.
Bye.